goes hard in the hole and scores! Portis leads, count the buckets! Justin Boulder finds an opening to running James, he scores! They go! Nick Brinkley! Oh my, what a shot by Nick! Here's Bland driving the baseline and scoring! Oh my! Justin Bland drove the baseline like a Shaquille O'Neal!
We gave him a taste of the Big Daddy, and they couldn't handle it.
Nice spin move, goes to the hole, lays it in! Oh, that was beautiful! Lightning quick, Justin Walter!
That is Justin Bland's 1,000th varsity point, and he's just a sophomore.
Little Bert Dickinson has just blocked the shot.
Chillicothe Hornets basketball on KCHI.
Start the bus!
Dogs down. Next, our mission was to beat the big town. Metro wins center from the city of KC. They like to run and gun and have much ability. When it was all over, we had the top score. Sorry, guy, off the final four.
I'm the man from the lane, trying to stop me results in pain. They call me Big Daddy for a good reason, because I'm in charge every single season.
We aren't real big, so our game is outfoxing. You better watch for Mike, the one they call Oxen. In games I like PT, but when I'm in, punks rarely step to me.
Our names are Bert and Wally, and we move like lightning. And when it comes to defense, we are quite frightening. We aren't elite scorers, but we hold our own by scoring needed points or breaking down the zone.
Hey, it's Fresh Frost. Yeah, I'm the boss. I take it coast to coast and move from guitar. I don't play a lot, so I'm rapping for the pine. But we support our Hornets all of the time.
I'm the 64, they call Nick. You double big dad, and I'll make you sick. Someday teams will respect me for what I am, or find out quick that I can be the man.
Don't try to tease me, just please me. Cause all of my friends call me easy. Basketball is what I like to do. You either guard me close or get treated like a fool.
Now at the final four, we have a major goal. A state championship, and we'll give our heart and soul.
This is how we do it.
Jeremy Miles. And for the Hornets, a 5'9
players step in at midcourt. It's Rico Saints and Justin Bland at midcourt, and we're ready to go here from the Hearn Center. It's tipped up, and Charleston will have it. Quickly into the front court, Larico Coleman. Top of the circle now to Jeremy Biles. Biles between the circles, backs it out of there casually with a left-hand dribble. Now he looks at token pressure out front by the two Chillicothe guards. They'll bounce it right wing. He'll swing to Rashad Oliver. They'll give him a little room. The ball knocked out of bounds by Eric Hemmer. And Charleston will maintain possession here. They'll pop it out front. With it is Larico Coleman, left wing. Now they go to the big guy, Corey Kent. Here's a baseline jumper from three. It's an air ball. Chillicothe with a rebound. Here come the Hornets. Now that ought to put some spark in that confidence by Chillicothe. Little Burt Dickinson at 5'10". Swings to Nick. Nick will put it down with a left-hand dribble. Guards up front, top of the key. There's the pass down to the baseline. Eric Hemmer, turnaround, finger roll, pinballs out. There's Bland. Has it knocked out of his hands? He throws it away. It's Chillicothe with the ball as that time Larico Coleman couldn't save it.
Opportunity missed by Chillicothe as two Charleston players were down on the floor away from the play.
Here's the inbound pass to Big Daddy. They'll swing to Nick. Nick out front. Justin Walter, we are just underway. We've ran off a minute. Neither team has scored. On the left wing, Burt. Burt looking inside. Nothing there. Now he puts it down with a belt-tied dribble. Works out front between the circles. Picked up there by Biles. They'll swing to the left side. Here comes Justin Walter to Nick. Nick with a head fake. Has it stripped. Hemmer has it knocked out of his hand. Bland retrieves it. Kicks it out. Real reset it. Boy, that ball was knocked around. Chillicothe still with the ball. And out front so far, I like what I've seen. There's Bland going to the hole, gets bumped in a foul. He'll go to the line, I think, Randy, as he was in the act of shooting. Hornets have a chance to take the early lead. Charleston is not a tall team. They go 6-3, 6-3, 6-3 on that front line. Bland's free throw. Yes! And the Hornets lead. Sit back and enjoy, folks. We're going to have a good one here tonight. I just feel I like the chances of Chillicothe. Second free throw. Pinballs out. Rebounds picked up by the big guy, Rashad Oliver. Here comes into the front court, Larico Coleman. Top of the circle, Larico with it. He'll look to the left side. Now bounces it that away, down to the baseline. There's Biles. Watch out. He can gun. He lets it fly and scores. Biles, they've got to cut him down, shut him down. He's averaging better than 16 points a game, and he pops that little J in the paint. Yeah, pops it home. Out front, Burt. Burt Dickinson with it. Dribbling out front, guarded by Biles. Now back door, there's Justin Walter, lays it in. Oh boy, it broke open, and there was Justin. He lays it in. Hornets lead it 3-2. All right, out front with it, it's Jeremy Biles. Biles double team, holds the ball high, stripped out of his hands. It's intercepted by Justin Walter. Here comes Chillicothe with a one-point lead. 5:50 left, first quarter. We are early. John Burt Dickinson with it out front. These guards are quick for Charleston. There's Nick putting the ball down top of the key. Stops his dribble. Swings down to Burt Dickinson. Burt now picked up by Biles. He'll swing to the baseline. The hammer. There's Nick. Whirl be free. Turn around. Jay! It's down! Whirl be free! Nick Brinkley! Oh, baby!
Oh, he steps his game up in the postseason.
I tell you, Nick can pop him. He's been having a hot hand of late. 5-2 on the baseline. There's the long three-pointer. Oh, he nails it. Larico Coleman has tied this thing up at five. Got to get a hand in his face. Got to get somebody on him. These guys will let it fly. Hornets have to be patient. Try to get a good shot every time down the floor. It's Justin Walter with the ball. Left wing up front. Now to the hammer. Down low. There's Big Daddy. Bingo. Bingo off the window. Hornets by two.
Big Daddy in the house.
7-5. Chillicothe with the lead. Here comes Charleston. The Blue Jays on the left wing. Larico. Now they'll swing it up front. Jeremy Biles. There's the lob inside and a collision. And the Hornets steal it. Nick Brinkley with a great defensive effort. Now Justin or Burt Dickinson, a three-pointer. It's no good. Hemmer falls the shot. Lays it up, but it won't fall. And Brinkley now fighting with his life. Gets the rebound. Nick with a great board. There's Burt with it out front. They'll swing down low. Hemmer nearly went out of bounds. It's stolen. No, he went out of bounds. Oh, my. We've got a game, folks.
But you've got to
keep that up. That'll pay off sooner or later. I like like the start here, Randy. I like it. The Hornets are a little bit afraid that they would get out to a slow start, have those butterflies, but they have handled it pretty good thus far. 7-5. Here comes Justin. There's Eric Hemmer. Three-pointer. Pinballs out. That thing was halfway down the hole. Here they come the other way. Larico Coleman with a rebound. Heel stutter step coming down the boulevard. Dishing it off. Throws it away. Justin Bland with a steal. Oh, he tried to come down the boulevard, and there stood the roadblock. Justin Bland, 6'6", 265 pounds. There's the dish and the paint that's knocked away, but a foul inside, and Big Daddy will go to the line. Chillicothe with a 7-5 lead. Slim, 7-5 lead. Big Daddy at the line. Get in there, big boy. No, he missed it short. He missed it short. A lot of real estate behind those backboards, Randy Dean. We are at the Hearn Center. Got to hit those throws, boys. Let's go. Justin will take his time. The bull looks at the bucket, lets it fly. Got it. 8-5. Chillicothe with a three-point cushion. Jeremy Biles picked up by Burt. Biles still with the ball, swings it on the right side, looking for the shot from downtown. Now goes in the paint, knocks out of his hands. Burt Dickinson got a hand on it. It's saved. It's loose. It's picked up by Pratt. Charleston came away with it. Great hustle by Chillicothe. Look at Jeff Snockenberg applauding the hustle on the defensive end. Here's a quick move. Giles got hooked by Nick Brinkley. Nick got him with the elbow, kind of locked horns there as he went around him, and a blocking foul on Brinkley.
Chillicothe foul. Nick Brinkley.
Oh, I tell you, Jeremy Bile, he is quick. He is quick to the hole. That first step, you can see the acceleration. They go into the high post. Turn around by Oliver. Good. Oh, my. He kind of forced that thing up. I don't know how it went in, but it did. 8-7. Walter with the ball way out front. Stutter steps, comes down the boulevard, dishes off. There's Burt with a three. Yes! Oh, baby! Oh, count it! Hornets go up 11-7. That's all right. It's all right. That's all right. In this first quarter, Chillicothe up 11-7. Charleston calling the timeout. They'll swing to the right side. Rashawn Oliver. Oliver holds the ball, cross courts it now over to the other guard, Larico Coleman. He lets it fly and nails the three. Boy, I'll tell you what, it's now 11-10. They just keep popping those threes. Chillicothe on the attack. Justin Walden left wing puts it down with a dribble. Now to Eric. Down low to Big Daddy. There's the shot blocked. And a foul is called on Corey Kent. That's all right. Bland will step to the foul line. And that's what they wanted to do that time and got it done, Randy. They pounded that ball into Bland in the paint. And Bland has a possession on Kent. Kent controls back to block that. Moe referenced a call that time. And at the line, it is Bland. Free throw up, and it is good. That away. Chillicothe up 12-10. Good start for the Hornets. Here's the free throw. Yes! It rolled around and dropped. 13-10. You feel like you need every point you can get. Hornets got the roll on that one. On the attack, Jeremy Biles. Now out front, it'll go to Larico Coleman. On the right wing, now to Kent. Kent beyond three, puts it down with a right-hand dribble. Now goes up front with a bounce pass, top of the circle. It'll go to Biles, the lob. Biles comes running down, stops and fires. Missed it short, follows his shot, and it goes in. Well, Biles stayed right with it. 13-12, Hornets by a point. Burt Dickinson breaks the timeline. 2 minutes to go, first quarter. I like the way the Hornets are playing this first quarter. Here's Justin Walter with a three-pointer. No, won't go. Rebound, Nick. Nick gets the rebound, fights it off. and now throws to Justin. Pull it pass to Hemmer. His shot won't go. Bland couldn't handle the rebound. Here comes Biles the other way. Biles will go to the hole, and look out, and a blocking foul on Dickinson. I don't like that one at all. Well, I thought he did, but that's a tough call. That's blocking or an offensive foul. It could go either way. They called Burt with a block. And the Hornets now leading by one in jeopardy of letting this lead go here as they'll shoot two free throws here.
He really needs to put the basketball through the hoop to get his point total start rolling.
At the foul line will be Rashawn Oliver. Free throw and he gets good. I noticed on the scoring stats for them through the air, this Blue Jay team, not the greatest free throw shooting team in the world, but they hit both of those. And they take the lead, 14-13. Here comes Chillicothe's Nick Brinkley now, and is still on the backcourt. And they pick up some pressure, just token pressure, as they break the timeline. Burt Dickinson now switching hands with a dribble between the circles. Right wing Nick Brinkley now put it down, accelerates down to the baseline. Still on the dribble, looks inside, now goes way up front to Burt. They'll swing around to the hammer. He spraddles up the three-point line, comes in the paint, turn around Jay, and he got the roll. Chillicothe back in the lead by a one. It's 15-14. Here comes Larico Coleman, drives, running Jay. No, he won't go. Pratt with a weak side board. Blocked by Bland. Inside the shot, and they lay it up. They missed it again, and Bland with a rebound. Here come the Hornets on the fast break. It's Burt Dickinson, alters his shot. Bland with a rebound, puts it up, and it won't fall. On the rebound, Charleston, they had a couple of chances, boys. Couldn't finish. Here comes Biles the other way, driving into Boulevard. Now kicks it out. Nice head fake, three-pointer. No. Rebound. Oh, Hemmer couldn't handle it. He tipped it out of bounds.
Good defensive adjustment there as they took the head fake and throw Bland out, but immediately Walker stepped in and played the defense. Now he ended up missing
it. Here's the inbound pass. On the right wing, the lob on the low post. They try to hustle their way in there. It's stolen by Justin Walter. That's a great play by Walter. He just reached his hand in there and picked his pocket clean. And here comes Chillicothe with a one-point lead. 31 seconds left. I think they're going to take the last shot of the quarter. Chillicothe with a chance to finish the first 8 minutes with a lead. Justin Walter with it down to the left wing. Beyond three, it's Burt down to 20 seconds. Hornets going to work for the final shot. Justin out front, accelerates down the paint, dishes down low. There's Bland. He scores! Bland with 13 seconds. Here comes Charleston with a chance now to pull it within one. 17-14 down to 4 seconds. And they're looking for a three. They let it fly. No good. Rebound inside. Hornets have it. Hornets have the lead at the end of the first quarter. It's Chillicothe 17. The Farm Boys from up north leading these guys down here from down around Cape Girardeau. The Charleston Blue Jays. It's 17-14. This is Hornets basketball. Columbia. Hornets have a 17-14 lead. Here we go. The second 8 minutes. Nick Brinkley trying to get it in and does to Burt. Burt will take it just on the backside of the midcourt line. Nope. Stepped out of bounds. Nick drug his foot. Oh, boy. An unforced turnover that time. Nick was standing right on the sideline. Did not know. Was not aware. His foot was on the baseline, Randy. Tough turnover.
8 points for Justin Lane. 2 each for Walker.
The Farm Boys up north lead the guys down south, running Jay by Biles, an air ball. Somebody might have got a hand on it, although I don't think so. And Chillicothe got the rebound off the missed shot that failed to draw iron. Out front it is Burt. Burt way up front, 735, swing down to the baseline. It's Justin Walter out front now to the hammer, top of the key, the lob to Bland. There's Big Daddy, his shot off the glass, too hard. It's scrambled and goes out of bounds. Charleston will have it. Well,
he's getting position on his defender, and however, they're collapsing the second man inside. He gets past the first one. He's only good on the second one. All the boys can jump. There's Lance Collard.
They can indeed, Randy. Maybe a head fake down there might sell some things down there for Bland. A good quick head fake, I think, to get his men and his defendant off their feet, maybe drive in there. And a little closer and a little better shot. Charleston with the ball, quick move to the hole. There's Larico Coleman. He's trapped, double-teamed. He stepped out of bounds! The Hornets double-teamed him down there, Randy. He had nowhere to go.
Again, defense, defense, defense. That's what's doing
Chillicothe leads it 17-14. We've gone 7 minutes left, first half. Neither team has scored here in the second period yet. It is Justin Walder out front on the left wing. Look out, Justin nearly lost it. Picking him up out there is Coleman. They throw it down and throw it away. Well, settle down, boys. Settle down. You hate to see him miss an opportunity to score down there, Randy. .640 left, first half. On the attack, right wing, it is Sinks. Here's a shot down low, blocked by Bland. Here comes Burt. The bounce pass to Walter, and he gets stripped of the ball, and he knocked. Oh, no. Oh, they gave that to Chillicothe. I thought the foul was committed, number one, and then I thought, okay, call it a blocked shot. It went out of bounds. Then they said it was blocked, and Walter last touched it. Oh, my. Ooh. All right, on the attack, down the paint, look out. There's the layup, and it's blocked, but they lay it back up and in. That time, Rashard Oliver stayed with it and got it. 17-16, Hornets need a bucket. They lead by one. Pratt picks up Hammer in the backcourt. A lot of pressure at the timeline. Now Eric breaks it with a dribble. Right wing, Nick. Lob inside, Bland. There's an easy one. Hornets score. It's 19-16. Watch Bland. They're going to try to pound it in there, and they got to try to stop him. Lorico Coleman with a trifecta. Boy, that guy can pop. I'll tell you, Randy, they tell us Jeremy Biles is the one to stop. Look at this Lorico Coleman. Man, he's popping the trays. There's a foul now on Coleman, the sophomore. Chillicothe and Charleston, we're tied at 19. Well, can the Hornets keep their head, keep pounding away, not be intimidated? Back door, there's the Hammer. He gives the head fake, goes up and scores. Oh, Eric Hammer on the back door. 21-19, Hornets by a deuce. They'll swing in the paint. There's the throw down on the low post. Horse in his way, traveling with the ball. You can't travel like that, buddy. He didn't want to go in there with that big bull. He said, I'm going to put a show on here. I'm going to hot dog this thing in. He did hot dog it. He traveled. On Nick Brinkley, right wing, way out front. We got Nick stepped out of bounds. You know, Nick, that's twice we've seen Nick step out of bounds over here right in front of the scorer's table, Randy.
Yeah, you've got to keep track of where that strike line is.
Well, I've always said in these big gyms, even though the floor is the same length, the depth perception is not the best when you get in this big place like the Hearn Center. There's a lot of real estate down there off the floor. Here's a pass down low. There's the baseline J. No good. Rebound by Pratt of Charleston. And now Charleston's getting the ball on the right wing to Corey Kent. Here's the jumper from Biles. No good. Rebound by the big guy Kent. He lays it up. Missed the shot. Hornets finally get the rebound. Brinkley gets it to Burt. Here comes Chillicothe. Hornets clear it out of there with a two-point lead. Pass down to the Hammer, now to Bland, hit him. Oh, and Charleston comes away with it. There's the traveling call finally with 4.5 left. Oh, boy, Randy, they finally got the call a little late.
You got lucky down here on defense. You can't give a team three or four chances at shots down here. There's three shots left in this one. All three. That ball a little bit better. I'll stop these football fancy passes. He's playing fundamentals.
All right, 21-19, Charleston trailing Chillicothe. Perhaps you remember Lamont Frazier, Ricky Frazier, the Missouri Tigers. He was from Charleston High School. Here's Burt down low, looks for the shot. There's Big Daddy. He missed it, but a block, and it's going to be on Charleston. I think the foul was on Leonard Gillespie. Leonardo Gillespie with a foul.
Charleston foul. Leonard Gillespie, first personal, 15 foul.
And he'll get two here. Put him in, Big Bull. First free throw on the way. No, he missed it. 21-19, Hornets by a couple. Bland has just missed his first one. He'll get another one here. Hornets hanging in there tough. Second free throw up, and it's good. Nothing but net on that one. So it seems when Justin has missed him, he's missed him short. And he got that one down. 4:15 left, first half. Hornets by three. 22-19. Charleston out front. They've lost only one game this year. Here's that guy again. He pops it home. Larico Coleman cannot miss. Here comes Justin Waller accelerating into the front court. He's triple team. The back door hits the backboard. A tough break. Look out. Slam a jammer upcoming. Oh, they thought he got ball. Burt Dickinson, if there was ever a good foul, that was it there. But I thought he got ball. That's a long ways from here. But nonetheless, even with a foul, Randy, a smart foul.
John Cotney foul, Burt Dickinson. That's his second.
All right, at the foul line, it's going to be Rashad Oliver. I thought he was going to dunk it. I think he wanted to dunk it. Burt Dickinson got back and stripped him of the ball, and Burt's coming out with two fouls. Brett Hecker's going to check in. So Hecker comes into the game. Hornets and Charleston at tied at 22. Free throw good. Second free throw, Charleston's free throw's good. So they hit them both. Rashad Oliver pops them both home. Chillicothe now down by two. They have not trailed by 2 points in this game yet. How do they handle it right here? Justin Walter, now to Brett Hecker. Brett will put it down, swings up front. There's the lob inside to Bland. Nice head fake. That's what I was talking about, but he missed the shot. He gave him a head fake, and they took a hook, line, and sinker. Chillicothe got the rebound out of there. Walter now swings to Hecker, left wing beyond three. Brett puts it down to the floor, has it stripped. Here comes Charleston the other way, and a foul. They had to foul him. Boy, I tell you, you got to handle the ball. Brett Hecker lost it out there. They are so quick, and then they was off to the races. Eric Hemmer had to foul him. He didn't have much choice, Randy. Well, they say he's a good one. Biles at the line, free throw, good. Nothing but net, 25-22. Now, the Hornets got to be careful here. You don't want to go down at the end of the half here big time. They've led most of this game. Second free throw, no good. He missed it. So the Hornets down by three. Need to go down here. Be patient. Don't be intimidated. Don't try to score 14 points this time down the floor. Get them two at a time. Get a good shot. Here's Justin Walter out front. He is stripped of the ball. Here's another turnover. They're going to go up and lay it in. Well, and they're not doing it here. They are now on an 8-0 run. Charleston up 27-22. Chillicothe's Nick Brinkley, right wing. He'll put it to the floor in a hurry. Drives down, running Jay. Good! Nick Brinkley, with determination in his eyes, goes down, pops the Jay. You know, that is a big shot by Brinkley. That thing doesn't go down. Chillicothe could be looking at a 7-point deficit. Now the jumper's good. Corey Kent pops it home. It's Charleston again with a 5-point lead. Here comes Justin trying to slow the tempo down. He walks it into the front court, swings to the left side to Hecker. 2:20 left in the half. Out front to the hammer. Eric puts it hard to the hole, drives down low, looks for the shot. Now lets it fly, missed it. Weak side rebound. It's going to be Rashad Oliver. His second half has not been good. Here's Brett Hecker with a steal. Brett jumped up and stole it. Now stops. There's the pass, and he throws it away. Oh, my. Brett Hecker stole the ball and then just threw it away. There was nobody there. Here comes the drive down low. The shot and a foul on Chillicothe. Well.
You've got to watch these fouls sooner or later. They might call Ryan Hicks for a foul.
Well, Burt's going to come back in. Burt's got two fouls. I don't think Snock wanted to put him back in here late in the second quarter, but he feels like his Brett Hecker's coming back out. And at the foul line is going to be Larico Coleman, who's been hitting about everything he's thrown up. Charleston leading by five. It's 29-24. And his free throw is up and in. 30-24. Hornets down by six. At the foul line, his free throw is up and it is good. He got them both. Burt Dickinson with the ball out front between the circles, picked up by Pratt. And now he stops his dribble. They swing to the baseline. Eric Hemmer with a three. Oh, he hits it. Oh, that's a critical shot, folks. Oh, that pulls them back to within four. They're down by seven. He misses that. We may be down by double digits here inside a minute and a half. That makes it a four-point game. And, boy, there's Lorico Coleman to answer. Well, they're not guarding him at all. I think they're trying to get on Biles. They're doing a job and a foul on Pratt. But they're leaving Coleman too much room. And Coleman is just having a night. And now a foul on Charleston. Chillicothe down by seven. It's 34-27 with a minute 12.
That's his first. 16.
Here's the inbound pass. It is Nick Brinkley trying to get it in. They get it into Justin. It's knocked out of bounds. You know, do you get the feeling there, Randy, that that you can play with these guys? I think this team can be beat. I'm not too impressed, although they are an extremely good shooting team, or at least they have been here in the first half. They have really been shooting the lights out. Here's Hemmer with a drive down the boulevard. Finger rolls it up and in. Nice play, Eric Hemmer at 34-29. Hornets hanging tough, down by five. This last minute could be critical, Randy, the last minute of the half. Coleman with the ball, right wing. Here's a shot off the no good off the back iron. Hemmer with a rebound. Eric got it. Boy, the Hornets, if they could come back and pull a couple shots in here late in the half, that would be a big mo booster right there, big momentum. There's Burt bouncing down to the baseline. Eric Hemmer with a three-pointer. Oh, he got fouled from three-point land, I think, Randy, and that thing pinballed out. It was. That thing goes down. It could be a four-point play. And anyway, here's Chillicothe now, who is looking at going down to double digit as Michael Snowden comes in. They were in danger of going down into the locker room, down by double digits, and now have a chance to pull it within two here at the end of the half. Yeah, that's good. You're right, Randy. He's getting him out of there. Here's the free throw by Eric. Good. Make them all, Eric. First one is down. He gets two more. 34-30. Well, we were down just last Saturday to center at the half. That free throw is good again. He got them both. Gets one more. 34-31. This is a big free throw here. 34-31, third one on the way. Good! 34-32, a two-point game, Randy. And it was starting to get scary there a minute and a half ago. Brett Hecker's back out there. Brett's going to be put on Biles. They're going to take the last shot with 20 seconds left. Here comes Biles working against Hecker. They'll bounce it between the circles way up front. It is Coleman. Coleman will just sit there and wind the clock to 10 seconds. Out front and out of Biles. They're going to take it to the hole. Watch Biles. Quick step. Working on Hecker. Comes in the paint. I thought he walked. There's Coleman. He'll stop and fire. He missed it with an air ball. And it's going to be out of bounds. And the Hornets dodge a bullet. And they have done well. At the end of the first half, our score, Charleston leading Chillicothe. 34-32, back in a moment. You're listening to Hornets basketball on KCHI. Yeah, that's shooting pretty good. 55% from three-point. I hope they don't continue that. If they can get that down about 40, we're going to win this game. Out front, here we go, second half, and Charleston will have the ball first. Out front, it's the little guy, Biles. Biles still on the dribble, left wing beyond three. He'll bounce off the blocks. Now the turnaround, Jay Leaner won't go. Rebounds loose, picked up by Coleman. Oh, boy. Coleman will have it. He looks for the shot, drives the baseline, dishes in the paint. There's the shot, finger roll, no good, but a foul. Stops everything, and it's on Chillicothe. And limping now is Coleman. Oh, boy. Lorico, how's the ankle, buddy?
Coming out of the halftime locker room.
That's actually foul. Nick Brinkley. Second personal.
They did. Rashad Oliver's free throw's good. Well, the report was they were average, and they are shooting much better than most teams. Here's the second free throw. Got that one. Nothing but the bottom of the net. Here. Chillicothe now on the ball. Here comes some full court man-to-man. They try to trap Justin Walter. He's still on the dribble. Hornets break the timeline. 3-on-1. Here's the shot by Burt. They beat it that time, baby. They beat him down the floor. Handle the press well. Burt Dickinson with a finish. Hornets down by a deuce. Here's Biles the other way. He rainbows. Won't go. Hammer with a board. Chillicothe can tie. Hornets can do it. Well, let's go, boys. Yeah, they backed that press off in a hurry when the Hornets beat that thing down the floor. Here's Chillicothe's Burt Dickinson with it. Now to the hammer, top of the key. He'll look inside. Now kicks it over the near side. Burt thinking about the three. Puts it down with a right-hand dribble. Out front. Now they'll swing to Nick. Nick on the right wing. Picked up out there by Rashard Oliver. And now here's Eric coming to the free throw line. Dishing left wing. Three-pointer on the way. That is no good. Here's Bland with a rebound. Go up, Big Daddy. He scores! It's tied at 36. Oh, the Hornets have come back from down by 7. They have tied it here early, third quarter. We got a game, folks. Right wing, Corey Kent. A lot of people said we had no business playing Charleston. We couldn't play with them. It's tied at 36. How's that for playing with somebody? Well, he got off of that ankle injury there pretty quick. He does not, I do not see a limp in Larico Coleman right now, and he'll shoot two. I think he's going to miss one of these, Randy. He's got two coming. First one is on the way, and it is good. Larico Coleman at the line, got the first one down, second one upcoming. And it is on the way, and it is good. He got them both. Well, he just continues to be hot from about everywhere on the floor, including the foul line. Here comes Justin Walter now to Burt, and he'll break the timeline with a belt-tied dribble. Accelerates now, changing the acceleration on the dribble. Right wing, give and go. There's Justin off the glass. He scores! 38-38. We're tied again. Six minutes to go, third quarter. Here comes Coleman driving the baseline, looking for the dish. Nobody home. Has to turn around and let it fly. And an air ball. Oh, they had nowhere to go. Coleman that time has been hot. Couldn't find the rim. Out front it is Burt Dickinson. Burt will put it down with the left-hand dribble. A bullet pass down low. Whirl be free with a head fake. Lays it up. Got fouled, I thought. Bland with the board. Lays it up. Missed it. Gets with it. Stays at finger roll. Missed it again. Oh, my. The Hornets couldn't finish. Bland had two chances. Couldn't get it to fall. Oh, I thought Nick got hammered. Here's a fast shot by Coleman. No good. Rebound. There's Nick. Boy, they're letting him play. I tell you, they're letting him go. Here comes Burt Dickinson, 5:15 left, third quarter. We're still tied at 38. Do you like this, folks? Look at the Hornet fans on their feet applauding. Little Burt Dickinson out front. Burt now switching hands with a dribble. Now accelerates between the circles. Look out. There's Bland, high post. There's Nick, back door. There's the shot. God, we're back in the lead, my friends.
What a great soft touch for Nick Brink. On baseline left.
What are we doing playing with these guys? We're not supposed to be in the game with Charleston at 29-1, number one team in the state. Here's a drive by the horse inside. Missed it. Rebound, Big Daddy. Come on, boys. Let's get some points up there. The long lead to Justin Walter. 40-38. Hornets with it. Eric Hemmer, top of the key. Now to Nick. Nick takes the shot, and he missed it. Rebound inside. That's Rashad Oliver. Nick has not missed many. That time didn't get the shot to go, and nobody was under the boards for Chillicothe. Chillicothe leading 40-38. Charleston with the ball. They've won 8 state championships. Charleston Blue Jays, what a dynasty. Here's a pass in the paint. They kick it back out front. There's Coleman, top of the key. There's a pass down the paint. Coming off running Jay. Good. Oh, he nails that thing on the run. That's Corey Kent popping one home. Good job of using the pick. 3:50 left, third quarter. We're tied at 40. Out front, Burt. Between the circles, high post. Bland, back door, bounce pass. Yes! Count it, baby! Back door on the bounce pass. Eric Hemmer with the finish.
Oh, I saw that back door coming from up here. Beautifully executed.
Out out front, Coleman. Get on him. Here's the lob, high post, way to the right of the paint. Turn around, looking for the shot. Forces it up, and it pinballs out. Rebound, it's loose. Picked up, blocked by Big Daddy. Look at Burke trying to save it. Burke Dickinson with a save. Unbelievable. Here comes Chillicothe. There's Whirl Be Free. It won't go. Tipped up. It's no good. Here comes Charleston now the other way. And they throw it away. They throw it away. Chillicothe with a ball. Holy cow. Look at the Hornet fans. They're loving it. Slow it down. Look at Snock holding up the red tee. The red tee, the red towel. What's that mean? That means, I don't know what it means. There's a pass down low. Look out. It's loose. Picked up by Bland. He gets fouled. We'll go to the line, baby. Hornets up by a deuce.
What happens when you wave the red flag? The bull comes charging, baby, and the bull.
Jeremy Miles, first personal.
Brett comes back in for Charleston. Bland will shoot two free throws. 42-40. Chillicothe with the lead. 2:51 to go, third quarter, and we got a timeout, so we'll take 60. You're listening to Chillicothe Hornets basketball on KCHI. Here's the free throw by the Bull. No, it's short. Oh, boy. Bland misses it short. Well, here's another free throw upcoming. Get it in there. That one's good. 43-40. Some of the folks coming by pointing at the scoreboard saying, I don't believe this. I don't believe what I'm seeing here. Chillicothe leading this Charleston team. We're not even supposed to be in this in the game. Out front, there's Coleman. Nice hit. Nice fake. They'll go down to the dish, down to the paint. There's a running J. They go hard to the hole. Block by Bland. He blocked it out of the gym. It's picked up, though, at midcourt. A three-pointer won't fall. Bland with a rebound. Here comes Justin Walter. Oh, my. You ought to have seen the Charlay Bull there. There's Bird. Yeah, something like that. Now to Justin Walter. Justin, look at him accelerate between the circles. Now the hammer. It's thrown away. Justin Walter got careless with a pass. Here's the driving layup, and he scores. Boy. Chillicothe leading by just one now with 2 minutes to go, third quarter. Justin Walter into the front court, picked up out front there by Coleman. They'll swing to the hammer. Eric now drives in with a left-hand dribble out front. Burt, Hornets need to score here. They need to just keep plugging away, getting a good shot. There's Nick going to the hole. The shot. We've got a foul on Pratt of Charleston. And then I think, that's going to be the second team foul on Charleston.
Watch Charleston. Charleston's hooking.
Down Chillicothe trying to get it in. Walter now up front to Dickinson. Bird will put it down with one dribble now. Right wing, quick pass inside. Big Daddy turn around. Jay missed it badly. Rebound is Bland. He goes up. He missed it. It's tipped up again. It's still loose. Himmer with a rebound. His shot won't fall. And now Himmer gets it back and scores. Holy cow. They were not going to be denied. One 17, and look at Charleston slowing the tempo down. Well, what do you know? A minute 11. Clock running. Hornets by three. 45-42. Now they go to the right wing. It is Corey Kent. Kent looking for the shot. Up front it goes. Swinging around the perimeter. Left side now to Coleman. There's the down off the low block. Turn around. Fade away. No. It's rebounded by the hammer. Here comes Chillicothe in the white. Here they come. Justin Walter accelerates and scores. 47-42, Hornets by five, three-pointer is good. Oh, he got the roll. He slopped it in. That's what he did. 47-45, that pulls him right back. Just when it looked like Chillicothe was going to do something, then Charleston comes back. Here's Burt with a three. No good. On the rebound, Charleston. 25 seconds. They can tie it with a deuce. Here comes Charleston now. Here's a drive to the paint. Looks for the shot. It's up. It's good. 18 seconds left. We're tied at 47. Just when it looked like Chillicothe was trying to build a bigger lead, here comes Charleston back to tie it. We're going down to the gun, boys. We're going to the gun. 8 seconds left. Here's Burke. There's Big Daddy. Count it. Count it. Hornets up by a deuce. That's going to be the end of the third quarter. Chillicothe with a 49-47 lead over the number one team in the state, the Charleston Blue Jays. This is Hornets basketball on KCHI. All right, back at the Hearn Center, Randy Dean and the Colonel here, and another dull night at the office. All right, here we go. 8 minutes to go, folks. Chillicothe hanging on to the two-point lead. They get it in to Justin Walter. Man, this is it. 8 minutes to go to the state championship for these two teams. Here's a pick by Snowden. Justin Walter breaks loose. They'll go to the right wing. Hammer now put it down with a left-hand dribble. Hammer now drives, gives it up to Burt. Burt top of the key, looking, bouncing right wing. Now the Hornets are going to spread it out. They're going to take a little time here, I think. There's Hammer, though. He breaks open, lets it fly, and missed it short. Oh, boy. Here comes Charleston the other way. Charleston bringing the ball down. There's Giles coming down. Biles with a running Jay. He missed it, and a foul on Snowden. Oh, boy. They don't want to put their guards on the foul line. Well, Snock's trying to get him a breather, Randy, but, boy, I'll tell you what, there's Michael coming in, and a foul there will put Biles on the line trying to tie it up. Here's the free throw. Good. Did they ever miss one? 49-48. This will tie it here if he nails this one. Biles at the foul line. Can't foul these guys. Free throw good. Nothing but net. They just swish every one of them. We're tied at 49. Nick Brinkley in the backcourt. Here's that press. Look out. They throw it away. Here's Charleston with a chance to take the lead. Oh, my. They pass it down to the left wing. Here's a drive by Coleman. He lays it in. And a foul, and you can count it. Uh-oh. Don't light a fire under him. Well, that's a shame. He was wanting to rest Bland, and he just can't afford to get him out of there for very long. Well, Michael. Well, two quick fouls on Snowden. He comes out. Bland, they got to get him back in there, and they have. And just like that, Charleston has taken a two-point lead, and at the foul line is Coleman again. Free throw. I don't suppose he'll miss it. He did! And a foul on Pratt! Holy cow, he finally missed one, and it's Pratt, who couldn't believe he missed, jumped over the back. Look at that guy. Look at Pratt. He looks like, ooh, I don't know. I'm not going to tell you what he looks like. Here's the inbound pass. Here's Justin Walter. Walter will put it down. Still in the backcourt. Hornets need to take a bucket here. Don't get rattled, boys. A lot of time. 7-0-8. The two-point game. Here's Justin Walter on the left wing. Still on the dribble. Top of the circle now. Explores the three-point line. There's a pass down low. Knocked away and it's stolen. It goes out of bounds. Still a guy that will have it. Almost a steal. Hornets a little tentative now on this possession down, it appears. Here's Nick Brinkley now slapping the ball, getting it in. There it goes to Justin Walter. Under 7 minutes now. Hornets down by a score of 51-49. Out front, Justin Walter between the circles. Right wing to Nick beyond three. 6:48 clock running. A lot of time. Nick Brinkley's double teamed. Somebody's open. There's a pass to Bland. Here's the head fake, the shot. Oh, he missed it from down low, and it's out of bounds. And Chillicothe is not going to get it. They're going to give it to Charleston. Hornet fans didn't like the call. Well, you know, Justin Bland, I think, is tired, but, boy, they put Snowden in there, and that didn't work very long, and they had to put him back in there. That shot was a little too hard off the glass, I thought. Out front, Coleman, look out. Hornets down by a deuce. Stay with them. Got to play the D here. Out front now, Corey Cantle want to take a little time off. Chillicothe could be tired here. Out front, Coleman. Coleman on the beyond three. They pass down low. There's the double pump. The shot no good. It's knocked around and laid in by Rashad Oliver. It's a four-point game. Well, there was nobody weak side that time. They had some white jerseys on the other side. This ball is knocked out of bounds. Chillicothe will have it. Looking at that press. They're down by four. Under 6 minutes. And they're trying to get it in. There's the bounce pass to Justin. And we got a foul, and it's going to be on Charleston. And that's Pratt. Well, he says something to his coach over there, Bobby Spencer.
His fourth personal.
And that's four team fouls. Both teams have committed four, so. Yeah, they do. Nick with the inbound pass. Got to hurry up. They get it in. They knock it away. They steal it. Here's the shot by Biles. They lay it in. Look out. Look out. Hornets getting on the verge. They need a bucket here. And they're down by six now. Just that quick. Just a little while ago, they were up by five. Now they're down by six. It's been an 11-point swing here in the last couple of 3 minutes. And it has come. Those points have come so quickly. Justin Walter, 5:35 to go. Justin falls down. Pratt just fouled out. He's gone. He's gone. He's out of here. Pratt has fouled out. Nick Pratt. And they fouled Justin Walter. Victor comes in. Pratt has fouled out. Chillicothe down by six. They will inbound. That is the 15 foul on Charleston.
Down by six right now.
Still a lot of time. Hornets very much in it. They need the ball and score a bucket and just try not to score 8 points every time down the floor. Get a good shot, get a deuce, and play the D. Eric Hemmer on the rebound. It's loose. It's picked up by Rashad Oliver. Yeah, I think they are a little tired. Out front with it. Knockenberg has tried to go to the bench, but is not. They have not got a lot of help off the bench here tonight. Out front with it's Coleman. He's between the circles. Picked up by Justin Walter. On the right wing, Coleman looking for the lob down low. There it is. Heart of the hole. It's up and it's no good and a foul. Boy, I tell you, hate to see him foul him because these guys just don't miss free throws. Hornets down by six and they have just shooting foul here. That'll put them on the line.
His third. 15 foul.
.451 left, still a lot of time, but at the foul line is Rashad Oliver. He's averaging 17 points a game, 6'3", pretty good sized boy. Free throw, no, he missed one, what do you know? Missed it short. Well, you know, 1 3-pointer and we're right back, we're still in the game, but I mean, 1 3-pointer, you're down by three, and then it's time to get excited again. Here's a second free throw. Yeah, he nails it, 7-point game now. Chillicothe with the ball. Justin Walter now trying to break the timeline with a dribble and does. Accelerates quickly down the floor, and the ball's knocked away. It's knocked away. It's knocked away. Oh, and Charleston will have it. Hornets turn it over. I don't know. Maybe Stock needs a timeout here. I don't. Well, they're down by seven. They were down by seven once before. Yeah, it's big. Here comes Charleston breaking the timeline. Ball, they tie him up at midcourt, and they get out of it. He got out of the trap. Here's the shot from the baseline. No good. There's the rebound, and it's Biles. He got fouled on by Eric Hemmer. Well, Randy, I think you hit it on the nail on the head while ago. I think they're tired. They're not boxing out like they were on the boards. And you get tired. There's a lot of things happens to you when you're out there on the floor. You don't shoot the ball as well as you did earlier. You don't box out. The mental thing starts affecting you, too. Biles is not tired. He continues to hit free throws. We got a timeout. 4.5 left in this game. Hornets down by eight. The biggest deficit in this game, 57-49. This is Hornets basketball on KCHI. All right. At the foul line is Jeremy Biles. And he will shoot the first one, and it is no good. He missed it. Well, he gives him a break. Bland with a rebound. Here comes Chillicothe's Nick Brinkley. Look out, Nick. They try to steal it from him in the backcourt. It's Walter. Justin accelerates into the front court now. Picked up by Coleman. Justin Walter, high post. Now they go to the top of the circle. Now to the left wing to Burt. Dickinson up front, top of the key. Now drives down to the edge of the paint. Bounce pass, laid up and in by Eric Hemmer. That's a big bucket. Four minutes. 57-51. Hornets are down by six. Out front with it, Biles. Look out. Dickinson nearly stole it. Boy, Burt was really hustling there on the defense. And Biles will have it out front. Biles put on a stutter step, comes down on a blocking foul on Dickinson. And that's going to be the 17 foul, isn't it, on Chillicothe? 9 left. Chillicothe down by 6. Charleston at the foul line. Free throw is up and it is good. .58-51, Chillicothe down by 7. Second free throw up, and it is no good. But they didn't box out, and the rebound, and the shot won't go. Bland with the rebound. Here comes Chillicothe, fast breaking down the floor. Himmer will take it. Himmer missed it. It's loose, and it's, oh boy, they could not finish. Himmer, too hard.
He thought about jamming it, but realized it didn't have space, and couldn't change the shot.
A breakaway layup is no good. 3:23 left in the game. Hornets down by 7. There's the shot, no good, and a foul on Bland. And that'll put him on the foul line again. 3:21 left. 58-51. Well, you know Missouri, you know how they do. They lost five straight in the Big Eight. Now they're down in the Big Eight tournament, and they're beating Oklahoma at the half. Free throw, good. At the foul line, Rashad Oliver. It's 59-51. Hornets down by 8. And the free throw is upcoming. It's on the way. It is good. He got the roll. It's a 9-point lead for Charleston. And here's the inbound pass, nearly stolen, picked up by Bland in the backcourt. Now Justin will take over. Walter trying a foul, a backcourt foul. That's 16 fouls now. Coleman didn't like the call. And the next foul, that will put Charleston over the limit. So the Hornets will have to inbound, and it's still in the backcourt. 3:18 left. That's the key right here. The two keys in the game, the time and the clock, or the time and the score. Down by 9 with 3:18 left is Chillicothe. Hornets now get it to Himmer. Himmer will come into the front court, left wing. They may want to think about a three, although there's the ball kicked around, picked up, and a foul. That's going to put him on the line. That's Coleman. That's Larico Coleman. Free throw, no good. He missed it. Well, the Hornets can't hit the free throws. You're not going to win the ball games. And Chillicothe down by 9 with 3:02 left. Charleston with it out front. It is Coleman. Coleman between the circles. Picked up by Walter, knocked out of his hands. And it's going to be picked up by Coleman. He's letting some air out of the ball here. Right wing out front. Now it'll go to Corey Kent. Kent now swing it way out front. They're just spreading them out. 2:45 to go. They're making it look good, but this is a semi-delay game. Biles is going to take some time out front. He'll put on a move, but he's going nowhere. He's standing at midcourt. Yeah, you're going to have to come out and foul him. They're going to, look at that. See, they're not looking for a shot. They're just dribbling around out front, and they're doing a good job of selling it, too. On the right, I don't know. That's a good question. Coleman with the ball out front. Now the foul comes, the grab, and it's going to be on. Coleman with the ball, free throw, no good. He missed it. Bland with the rebound. Here come the Hornets. Here comes Justin Walter into the front court, 2:17, looking for the dish. There's Burt. He'll drive down to the baseline. His shot on the way, no good. Rebounded by Nick. His shot pinballs out, and it gets away. 2:05 left. They cannot finish it. Nothing will fall, and now Himmer in the backcourt. 2:03 left. Hornets down by 9. Hornets keep fighting here. The press is going. This is quite a game. We're surprised you guys are even in the game. Free throw up and in, a 10-point lead. Second free throw is upcoming. It is on the way, and it is good. You got the roll. 62-51, 11-point lead now for Charleston. Here comes Chillicothe, long lead. They throw it away, and this game is about over. Charleston will inbound, and it'll be Biles in no big hurry. The guards are going to handle the ball, and that's what you should do. When you're leading, you want your best free throw shooters with the ball, and they're going to dribble out front, and they're going to come out and make you foul. There's the back door. They had a chance at the shot, turned it down. Wisely kick it back out, milk some more clock. Chillicothe has to foul. It's Justin Walter. And he fouled Derek Coleman, or rather, Larico Coleman. No, you look up, and golly, it's Charleston up by 5. How do they get from 5 down to 5 up? And that's how quick they can put points on the board now as Coleman hits the other one. Chillicothe, I don't think this team's a bit better than Kansas City center that we played last Saturday. Here come the Hornets now in a hurry. Here's Justin Walter with a three-pointer, and he nails it! A three-pointer, 63-54. That's a nine-point game with a minute 28 and a quick timeout by Snock. Froze, don't they? All right. All right, the Colonel and Randy Dean here at the Hearn Center. While we were away, Charleston hit two free throws, and Chillicothe with the ball now. The three-pointer ball for Emmer, and Charleston has the ball with a minute 8 left, and a backcourt foul on Justin Walter with a minute 7 left, and Chillicothe trailing now by 11. Win or lose this one, they'll either play at 6:05 tomorrow night or 9:45 as the free throw is good. And it's beginning to look like 6:05 tip-off tomorrow night for third place in the state. In Class 3A, that's not too bad. Yeah, you bet. There's the throw. Oh, they finally missed one, but they got their own rebound. We're just tired. We're tired, boys. And here comes Chillicothe now into the front court, down by 14. This final score, everybody's going to see the score, and they're going to go the game. Chillicothe led by 5 late in the third quarter. Here's a running J by Eric Himmer, who nails it. It's the Hornets down by 12, 68-56, 48 seconds left, and a foul. He stepped out of bounds, or did he? What'd they call? I don't know. A run, and really a break here and there, but isn't a game of sports all a break here, a break there? Isn't life like that? A break here, a break there. Said Randy, three sophomores, a junior and a senior, free throw, no good. Comes one out of two from the foul line. Chillicothe's Brett Hecker with a three. It's no good. Rebounded by Robbie Gastineau. Robbie will put it down. Throws to Himmer. Three-pointer. No good. Missed it. It's kicked out of bounds. I think Chillicothe will have it. Robbie Gastineau fighting for the board down there. Well, that's right. And they're not quitting, boys. I'll tell you right now. They are still fighting, Chillicothe is. They're down by 13, inbound pass knocked away. Charleston, they're not quitting either. They're scrapping out there. Well, folks, we hope we got a game tomorrow night yet, and I guess that's going to be the last one of the year. We've been on the road doing a lot of games since late November. It's been fun. One more, a big one tomorrow night. Let's all get down here. Let's don't forget about these guys. Let's try to make it down tomorrow night. Door Hecker, they throw it away. Well, Hornets turn it over with 29 seconds. Charleston 69, Chillicothe 59. Folks, we want to tell you to stay loose. Have a run, folks. And they fell a little bit short. I think they kind of ran out of gas a little bit in the fourth quarter. 69-59 was the final. and we'll be back. You're listening.
California.
Right to left here in this first half. Justin Bland will jump into midcourt with Gabe Craighead, and this game is just about underway. The official now steps into the circle. We are live from the Hearn Center in Columbia, home of the Missouri Tigers, and we are underway. Fulton grabs a tick quickly into the front court, down to Reeder. He forces his way to the hole. It's blocked out of bounds by Big Daddy. Nice block by Bubba.
Bland had good position that time.
Here's the inbound pass, upcoming. They throw it way out front, intercepted by Burt. Here comes Dickinson, zigzagging his way down the paint. He's double-teamed, kicks it out now to Eric Himmer, right wing, down to the baseline. Here's Burt with a three, missed it short. Follows his shot, it's knocked out of bounds, and the Hornets will get it. A hustling play by Burt Dickinson, and that's how the Hornets retain possession. The pass to Bland, inside off the glass, no good. Tipped up and no good by Himmer. It's still loose, picked up by Nick Brinkley. In the paint, the head fake, the J won't go. Himmer lost the rebound down low. It's picked up by Craighead. Here comes Fulton the other way. We're scoreless here with about 30 seconds into the game. Up front, top of the key, it'll go to Matt Reeder. Now to Perry on the left wing, beyond three. He goes to the free throw line. Now to the right wing, down to the corner, stands and pops away, lets it fly, and he hits it. That's Matt Reeder. He can score from anywhere. Woody's foot on the line. Chillicothe down the other way. Eric down low. Justin Bland shot up and it falls out on the rebound. It's Ryan Rist. Chillicothe failing to hit a shot here. They've had their chances from down low. Their shots haven't fallen yet. On the attack, right wing, Kirby. Kirby out front, Perry now between the circles. Picked up by Burt Dickinson. He'll put it down with a right-hand dribble. Still backs it out of there. Still on a dribble now out front. Bounces it up way out at midcourt to Brian Kirby. He's picked up by Justin Walter. Kirby accelerates right wing with a right-hand dribble. Out front now to Perry. Top of the circle. Lob back door. Alley-oop. They throw it away. There was nobody home, Randy Dean. Here comes Burt. He's double-teamed at the midcourt line. Out of Eric Himmer, right wing, stops and pops, and it won't drop. Hornets not there on the back side of the boards. Here comes Fulton now with a 2-0 lead. Both teams opening cold. Out front, top of the circle, it is Matt Reeder. Now to the right wing to Perry. Now top of the circle to Craighead. He'll stop and let it rainbow, and he hits it. Craighead from the free throw line. It's 4-0. And they've had their shots, too. Most of them have been inside 6-8 feet. but they have yet to hit. Eric Kimmer now banks it out of there. Right wing now to Burt beyond three. Burt between the leg dribble, left hand now, swings it up front to Justin Walter. Justin left hand dribble it, now swings to the near side. It can go to Nick Brinkley. He drives down the baseline, looks for the shot, dishes in the paint. There's Big Daddy, his shot up and in. Oh, Big Bubba. Bubba with a basket. Matt Reeder's pass intercepted. Here comes Burt Dickinson. Burt into the front court now, switching hands with dribble. Hornets can tie it here as a pass down low. Nick, turn around, fade away. Yes! That thing pinballed around and finally fell in the hole. We're tied at four. Fulton now the other way. Right wing, Reeder goes off the low block. Kick out Perry. Long range ball. Missed it badly. On the rebound, it's picked up by the Hammer. We're tied at four. Chillicothe with 5:05 to go. First quarter. We got a good start here. Close game. Hornets have been cold. So is Fulton. Here comes Little Burt down the edge of the paint. Kicking it now to Justin. Walter now swing up front to the Hammer. Inside to Big Daddy. Turn around Jay. Nothing but net. 6-4 Hornets lead. There's a pass in the paint, intercepted. Chillicothe comes away with it. Well, Justin Walter came up with a loose ball. I think it was Bland got a hand on it. Here comes Chillicothe the other way. Burt Dickinson with it. 4:32 left in the first quarter. Chillicothe on a 6-0 run after they fell behind 4-zip. Out front, Hammer inside the paint, knocked away by the big guy. Here comes Perry the other way. Down low, there's Craig Head. Backhanded finger roll goes down. We're tied at six. Here comes Justin. Walter now drives down low, bounces pass. Here's Nick breaking wide open. Bingo, it's down. 8-6, Hornets on an 8-2 run here as they have taken the lead again. Perry with it out front. Now they'll swing to Kirby. Kirby between the circles, the little vacuum cleaner. Kirby swings left wing. How'd you like that? Perry. Back door turnaround. Jay rims out on the rebound. It's Big World Be Free, Nick Brinkley. And he'll feed to Walter. Now he'll get back to Burt. He'll walk it across the timeline with a belt high left-hand dribble now. And he'll work to the left side, way out beyond three. He's in front of the Fulton bench, up front now, top of the circle. It'll go to Nick Brinkley. Now to Justin down near the baseline. Back to Burt. Now the right wing to Hammer. Back to Burt. Swinging around. Good ball movement. Right back to Burt. Top of the circle. Near side. Now here comes Hammer. Hammer now bounces low blocks. There's a cross court pass thrown away. No, it's picked back up by Walter. Oh, Nick's pass nearly intercepted. Walter with a dish in the paint. Big Daddy with a jumper. Missed it short. Gets his own rebound. Hard to the hole he goes. Head fakes it up. It won't fall. On the rebound, Matt Reeder. Oh, boy. We're under 3 minutes. Hornets with an 8-6 lead. Chillicothe now on the defensive end. As up front, it'll be Brian Kirby. Swinging it now, right wing to Perry. There's the backdoor alley-oop, and the timing's not there. The shot is not there. The rebound is not there. It goes out of bounds, and it's going to be Fulton's ball as two Chillicothe players, I think, got to play in volleyball, tipping it back and forth and went out of bounds off of them. Here comes Perry with the inbound, lob inside, a foul. It's going to be on Bland, or could it be on, well, let's see, Nick was there too. I think they called it on Big Daddy. 2:42 left, and here's the inbound pass, and they bank it home. Ryan Rist, that was too easy. We're tied at eight. 2:35 left, first quarter. Chillicothe with the ball. We're tied at eight apiece. Head of the front court, Burt Dickinson swings to the other side. Now to Justin Walter, right back to Burt between the circles. Right back to Justin now, down low to Nick. Nick backs his way into the corner, swings it out of there. Good ball movement through the triangle. The turnaround, Jay, won't go. Bland, oh, they called a foul on Big Daddy. He pushed off, I think. Bland had the rebound. He was all alone, but he said he shoved off, and he's got to come out, I think. You got to get him out of there. Two fouls at the 2:16 mark, first quarter. And I think you're going to see Snowden there pretty quick. Here comes Kirby. Now to Perry of Fulton. Fulton Hornets with the ball up front, top of the key. They drive down the paint. There's a shot up and in by Matt Reeder. Well, they're going to challenge Bland now. He's got two fouls. They're going to take it to him and say, come on, you want to stop us? You can go sit on the bench for a while with three. He's got two now. Burt Dickinson out front, left side. Now they go the other way, right back to Burt. Burt beyond three, passes in the paint. The ball knocked away and it's kicked out of bounds off Bland. Hornets will have it. Well, I think, I don't know. Now checking in will be Rodney McNeil for Fulton. They're going to get Brian Kirby out of there. So far, Bland's in there. And I'm a little bit surprised that Snock's gone with him with two fouls. A minute 33 left, first quarter. On the left wing, it is Perry. They'll swing up front, top of the key. There's Reuter. He'll drive. There's a shot in the paint, and that goes down. Reuter's tough. Matt Reuter, the 6'7 junior, and it's now 12-8. Hammer way out beyond three. They'll swing it around to the other side, Justin Walter. Justin will dribble up front, down the top of the key, swings it down to the baseline, hammer down out of Burt. On the wing, beyond the three-point line. Burt takes a three-pointer from downtown, nails it! Yes, Burt! Burt Dickinson from downtown. And I said earlier before we started the game, Randy, that these guards of Chillicothe are going to have to look for the shot. That's got to loosen up the inside. Turnaround jumper. Boy, they can hit Ryan Wrist. Bland is just laying back. He's afraid to come after him. And they're having their way inside against Bland thus far. Hammer now to Burt. I like to see Burt and Justin both get hot from three-point land. And they are both streaky-type shooters. And Burt nails his first three of the night. That's got to help his confidence. Down to 25 seconds. There's a three-pointer on the way. Good! Burt Dickinson hits another one. Oh, baby, we're tied. Fulton has the ball up front. Free throw line, Jay. We got a foul on Fulton with 8.5 seconds. That's going to give Chillicothe the chance to come down and score. Seven, now they've wound the clock down to 7.6. And Bland has come out of the game, and Michael Snowden has come in. Hornets with 7 seconds, and Burt picks it up in a hurry. Look for the three. They may go for another one. Here's the shot. It's no good. It's knocked out of bounds by Snowden with 1 second, actually 1.9 seconds. And now Fulton will get a shot. We're try to inbound it anyway. We're tied at 14. Inbound pass, baseball type, top of the key. Look out, they got it away, and they missed it. Oh, I thought that thing was going in. That's the end of our first quarter with a score. The Fulton Hornets 14, the Chillicothe Hornets 14. You're listening to Hornets basketball on KCHI. Pick up some of the guards out there. They'll go to Justin the other side. Down to the baseline, the pass to Snowden, the shot, the finger roll, partially blocked. And here comes Fulton now the other way. Perry with a drive, lays it up, won't go. The rebound up and in by Matt Reeder. Reeder lays it in, and here comes Justin Walter. Now to Burt Dickinson, 7:22 left in the half. Chillicothe down by a deuce, 16-14. Walter with it, now to Burt Dickinson. Swings the right wing, then the hammer. Eric now swings it around. They go to the other side beyond three. Top of the circle, there's Burt, fake the three. Justin will let it fly, and his shot won't fall. A rebound and a foul over the back as Fulton's Gabe Craighead. It was Nick Brinkley, I think, with a position down low. Here's the inbound pass to Walter. Hornets will have it. The pass. There's Nick breaking open. A little shot from down low. He can't finish it. Oh, boy. Missed about a four-footer. And here comes Fulton now the other way. 16-14 lead. Fulton with it out front. It is McNeil. McNeil stutter step, swings right wing beyond three. Way out front to the big guy, Reeder. They'll swing down low. There's McNeil. And the layup good and a foul on Walter. They'll count the bucket. Well, they forked it down low off the post and a little bit of a mismatch down there. Walter against McNeil. He laid it in. The foul was called. And Fulton goes up by four, perhaps five, if the free throw goes down here. Free throw, rims out. Rebound. Nick Brinkley. Well, they missed a free throw. Here comes Zurich up the near sideline. Bounces it right wing. It'll go down to the baseline. Burt looks for the shot. Double team. Throws it way out front. Justin Walter. He'll retrieve it. Now they'll come to the right wing again. Burt. Now to Michael. A long range. Jay missed it short. Rebound comes way out of midcourt. Picked up by Burt. Hornets will have another shot at it. Down by four. Burt Dickinson on the right wing. He cross courts it over to Eric Hemmer. Eric now in front. Justin. Good ball movement. There's the three-pointer on the way. It pinballs out. Rebound Fulton. Ryan Riz came out of there with it. Here they come up the far sideline. It's Reeder. Reeder switching hands with the dribble, kicks it out. Long range three-pointer. It's no good. The shot came up by Perry, and now Nick Brinkley with a rebound. Nick will get it to Justin. Here come the Hornets with 6 minutes left, first half. They'll throw it into the right wing. There's Nick breaking open. Right wing Jade. Bingo. 18-16, Chillicothe behind by a deuce. Perry with it out front. He likes to throw up the threes, and they've been right on him. Burt's been on him. McNeil has it left wing now with Walter. All right, right in his face. Now at the free throw line, McNeil. Here's a long range, Jay. It won't go. Too hard off the back iron. The shot from Craig Head wouldn't go. The rebound by Chillicothe. 5.5 to go, first half. Hornets down by a deuce. Burt Dickinson with a word as he passed right by Jeff Snoggenberg. There's the pass to Nick. Baseline. He'll let it rainbow and missed it badly. An air ball. Here comes Fulton now the other way. Long lead from Perry down low. There's Reeder going to the hole. Mismatch there. Shot pinballs out. Rebound Hammer. Here comes Chillicothe now up the net. Now Burt will cut it towards midcourt. Burt now on a right-hand dribble. Slows it down. Throws to the right wing to the Hammer. 5 minutes left. Looks for the shot. They'll go back to Burt. Right wing. Switching hands with the dribble. Backing it out of there. The pass to Snowden. He lost the handle. Snowden, they caught him flat-footed, it looked like. That pass, he was not able to handle it. Fulton now the other way. Bland is on the bench with two fouls. 4:40 left. First half, Hornets down by a deuce. McNeil, right wing, pass knocked away. Hammer went for the steal. Oh, I thought he got away with a walk. Here's a drive. I thought he walked with a ball. They didn't call it. Instead, they want a foul down low. With Snowden coming back out, we got Kerry Bush has checked in. Shot up and in, 20-16 on the inbound pass. That was too easy. Chillicothe now the other way with Justin Walter. Justin will come and work at the front of the now picked up. Look out. They knocked it out of his hands. He retrieves it at midcourt. Justin now, top of the circle, swings to Hecker, right wing. Brett with a left-hand dribble, throws it away. Oh, that's a terrible pass. Hecker just threw it right into the hands of Perry. And a timeout by Jeff Snoggenberg with 4 minutes left. First half, Hornets have fallen behind by six. And you're listening to Hornets basketball on KCHI. 1 minute. And he's brought him right back out. That last pass a little bit telegraphed. And well advertised. It was intercepted. And Chillicothe lost a couple of points there. So now Gastineau. Here's the pitch down low to Hammer. Off the window. What a shot. And he was fouled. Oh, that was a quick release off a shot, Randy. Craig here with a foul. Free throw up and in. A three-point play has been finished off here. 22-19. Hornets down by three. So a big three-point play the old-fashioned way from the Hammer. On the right wing, it's Bush. Bush will put it on the right wing down to the base, or down to the three-point line. Out front, they'll swing it around. It goes to Craighead. Now the left-wing jumper by Perry. He missed it short. Brinkley with a rebound. Here come the Hornets with a three-on-one. It's a nice fake. The shot up and in. That's the way to run it. Gastineau with a bucket. Justin Walter with a great fake. Boy, that's the way to run it. Three-on-one. Justin Walter giving the ball up at the right time, and the Hornets have pulled it within one. So the last timeout by the Snock got them fired up. Craig hit out front. Perry now will take charge. On the other side now to Bush. They'll go to the baseline to Kirby. Up front now to Perry, swinging around Craighead. Now near side of the baseline, it goes to Bush. He'll put it down, one harmless dribble. Out front, they'll swing it around now between the circles. It is Kirby. Down to the baseline, far side, give and go. The big man inside, fadeaway Shea, and they call a foul, and the basket's good. And the fans from Chillicothe think that's call stunk. And Fulton in the lead by three. Free throw up, and it is good. So Chillicothe now the other way with it. Burt Dickinson, he'll break the timeline. Double team. They set up a trap there. They go down low. Nick Brinkley driving a baseline. He gets cut off. Eric Hemmer will let it fly. Won't go. Rebound inside. Look at Gastineau battle for the boards. Look at Gastineau. Look at him go. Look at Gastineau. Look at Gastineau. What a play by Robbie Gastineau. That's hustling your butt off. That was a great play, a great hustling play. He just would not quit, Randy. And now here's a shot. Now what's that? I don't know how that's not a foul. Nick's shot was blocked. It looked like he got him on the hand pretty good. Here's Fulton the other way, cross-coordinate. Perry driving a baseline. Nice spin move. Lays it up and lays it in. Well, I thought he walked there. And here comes Chillicothe down the other way. Hornets down by six, 27-21. Here's Burt with it out front, right wing. He'll swing now to Robbie Gastineau. Gastineau will put it down out of Burt, and he'll bring it down with a right-hand dribble. Now looks inside. There's the ball knocked out of bounds. Chillicothe hanging in there. Eric Hemmer will get ready to lay it in. And he throws it on the right. Look out. Robbie Gastineau picks it out of midair. Looks for the shot. Instead goes to Holder down to the baseline. Michael now swings up front. Gastineau. And he looks to the other side. Now swings to the near side to Walter. Justin will put it down out front harmlessly with the dribble. Now between the circles, the high post. There's Hemmer back to Walter. Look out. Robbie had to retrieve it. Gastineau now swings to Holder. Bounce pass in the paint. Thrown away. Holder's bounce pass was not there. 27-21. Here comes Fulton the other way. Down to a minute 10 left. First half. Here's a shot. They fake the shot rather in the paint. They'll kick it out front. Now they'll swing to Kirby. He looks for the shot. Perry now lobs it down low. There's Reeder and he lays it in. Well, there's a big mismatch out there when Bland is down, and we have not seen Bland in the second quarter. They are resting him, and Reeder's having his way at 6-7 down there. Here comes Burt with 44 seconds left. In the front court he is, guarded by Kirby. Yeah, getting down by eight. You want to hold it in single digits. That just feels better. It looks better. And when you get down by double digits into the locker room. Well, Walter nearly lost the handle. Picked up by Burt. He'll dribble out front. Looks like the Hornets want to take the final shot here. Burt Dickinson now to Justin Walter. Double teamed at midcourt. And a foul on Perry. Now they will have to inbound. And Fulton probably likes that to see him inbound the pass. He'll put pressure on the passer and the inbound receiver. And it's Burt with 17 seconds and working into the front court now. Burt with the stops his dribble, looks to the near side now to Gastineau, swing to Hemmer. Three-pointer is no good. Rebound tipped up and grabbed by Reeder and a foul on Gastineau. Work it down for the final shot. The three-pointer wouldn't fall, but in the foul, the weak side rebounding by Gastineau. He reached in and fouled. Here comes Fulton the other way. Got to hurry. 3 seconds. He'll take a mid-court shot. It is no good, and it's tipped up and no good. And the Hornets might have dodged a bullet. Hemmer jumped up into the net, and that ball hit the rim from midcourt. Fulton goes into the locker room with a 29-21 halftime lead. We'll be back in a moment. You're listening to Hornets basketball on KCHI. The difference in the game, the big man inside, Mr. Matt Reeder, the horse, went to work and had his way and hit, what do you say, Randy, 14 of 18 in the paint?
They were from inside the three-point range, they were 14 of 19.
Good night. That's torrid shooting, my friends, 14 of 19. Inside two-point land. All right, here we go. Second half is underway. Brian Kirby works it into the front court. Left wing, it'll go to Craighead. Out front between the circles now to Kirby. They'll go to Perry on the right wing beyond three. Picked up by Burt. They'll swing to the top of the circle again. Now the other side to Reeder. Reeder's popped out high. Now high post. It'll go to Wrist. He'll drive in the paint. Dish to Kirby. Now coming down is Craighead. He'll stop and pop, and he hits it. Boy, that's good shooting. Again, that's 15 out of 20 now. That's 75%. Even I can figure that one. You shoot 75% from the floor, you're going to win. It, thrown away by Nick Brinkley. Here comes Fulton now the other way and a foul. Oh, a traveling is called. You're right, Randy. I thought it was a foul. Yeah, they reached in, and I thought it looked like an arm wrestling match. And here comes Justin now the other way. Nice pass in the paint. There's Big Daddy banking it in. Stay out of foul trouble, big boy. 31-23, 7 minutes to go, third quarter. And they go down low. Now they cross-court it at the edge of the paint. The shot won't go. The rebound. Oh, Fulton says, look what I found. Doggone, they got lucky. Craighead found it right in the paint and laid it in. It's a 10-point lead for Fulton. Dickinson to Walter. Justin will swing now to Eric. He pops the three. Rimmed out. Rebound. Look at Nick. Fight for the rebound. Here's Justin. Walter nails the three. I keep saying this. Our guards have got to have to start shooting the threes. Open up that middle. Perry to Kirby. Now to Reeder. They go low block. And back to wrist. They'll go now to Reeder on a baseline near side. Picked up by Brinkley. And Reeder will swing it out front now to Craighead. Way out front to Perry. They'll swing to Kirby on the left wing beyond three. He'll put it down, wastes his dribble, throws down low. There's Reeder. That's not any fun, but he missed it. But then he gets his own rebound and lays it in. Well, even when he misses one, he's right there. And he's going to pick it up off the rim and put it back. Eric Hemmer down to the baseline. Bland's got to be careful. Here's Eric Hemmer's sop and pop. Can't hit it. Tipped up, no good. Rebound, it's Perry. Here comes Fulton the other way with a 9-point lead. Into the front court. Here they come down the paint. The running J is good by Perry. Here's Justin Walter with it into the front court. Walter now puts it down, swings down to the baseline to Burt. Now to Justin Walter. I think a lot of folks have to remember whatever. There's a steal by Wrist or Craighead. He'll take it up and lay it in. Oh, he missed it, but nobody got back. They missed it again. Good Lord, they missed two layups and nobody was there following the play. And finally, the Hornets got back and fouled them. Puts them on the line. Well, Justin's got a, he's going to be coming out here pretty quick, I think. Here's a shot by Craighead. Won't go. Rebound Bland. Here comes Chillicothe now the other way, down by 11. That's the biggest deficit of the game for the Hornets. They'll look inside, and the ball thrown away. It's going to be retrieved, though, by Michael Holder. Holder down will swing over to Walter. Walter, quick step to the hole, and it's knocked out of his hands, and now it's out of bounds. Perry got a hand on it. Chillicothe down by 11. They'll retain possession with the inbound pass upcoming from the baseline. 4:53 to go, third quarter. Inbound pass. There's Bland. It went right through his hands and out of bounds. Yeah, here comes Fulton. Now the Hornets in the black and gold against the Hornets in the black and red. Actually, the Hornets in white uniforms here tonight, but that's their colors. Here's the Hornets in black and gold coming down the paint. We got a foul on the drive, and that's going to be on the Hornets of Chillicothe. And the foul is on Bland, I think. Yes, now that is true, and that's pinballs in the free throw, and that's going to be tough. Bland is in there now with three fouls with 4:39 to go, third quarter. At the foul line, Craighead hit the first one, and he will also get the second one. It's a 13-point lead for Fulton. Chillicothe now with Burt Dickinson into the front court. I had a gut feeling this could happen here. Chillicothe behind by double digits here. I saw Fulton last night. I was impressed with him. Mexico, I don't see how Charleston can beat Mexico in the final. Here's a shot, jump hook. It's good by Nick. This thing a long ways from over, by, I'm not saying it's over. What a, wait a minute. A technical foul has been called. Oh, boy. Well, they just called a foul on Chillicothe, and I don't know who it was on. Jeff Snockenberg is staring down the bench. I don't know who was. Well, I don't know. He is out. Justin Bland has fouled out with his fourth foul and then the technical, and he's out of there. Oh, my. Justin Bland, who never says a word, never shows any emotion, never has picked up a, I don't know what he said, but the official was right there and slapped him with a tee, and I guarantee you he didn't ask him what he had for breakfast. He is gone, Bland is out, free throw is up and no good. Well, the Hornets, I don't know. They are now at a big mismatch against Fulton, who runs 6'7", 6'7", 6'4", on the front line, and the Hornets' big monster is on the bench, done for the night with 4:23 left. Craighead misses both free throws. Yeah, the shot went in by Chillicothe. Bland was called for the foul after the shot, and I don't know what he said. I can't imagine it being anything too, as mild-mannered as Justin Bland is. I mean, here's a shot from downtown. It rims out. Rebound. They lay it in. Well, again, Nick Brinkley had the rebound. He just took it out of his hands and laid it in. Hornet fans went into foul. They didn't get it. Burt Dickinson now will swing to Holder. On the right wing, Holder looking inside, bouncing it out front. There's Nick and a foul there. And they better call that one because that happens right in front of the fans. Some of the fans over there. And it's really some of the women over there, Randy, that makes it fun. Now you look over there, some of the women over there are just jumping out of their shoes. I like to see the women get into the game. They're into it over there. I'm not going to mention any names. Oh, they're into it. Chillicothe down by 13. There's the back door. There's Nick. Bingo. 11-point lead now for Fulton as Brinkley pops it home. It's 41-30, 3:40 left. A lot of time still in the game, but, boy, our mismatch on size is awesome. Here's the shot rimmed out. There's the rebound again. Oh, and they call a shove-off on Ryan Rist. Well, I wouldn't want him using his hips on me. He's pretty big. And he got Nick Brinkley, just shoved him out of the way, and Nick clapped his hand. Oh, and the Hornets throw it away. An unforced turnover. There was nobody there, nobody home, and that was just a poor pass. And well, 3:22 left. And a timeout by Fulton. I was just going to say I thought maybe Schnock ought to get one here, but Fulton calls it. 3:20 left, third quarter. Hornets down by 11. It ain't over yet. Hang in there. This is Hornets basketball on KCHI. I don't know. Back here at the Hearn Center in Columbia. Fulton will inbound. Eric Hemmer has just knocked the ball out of bounds. He went in front of the defender. It was a good defensive play, but it went out of bounds, and now a foul call. Well, that time Bert thought he got ball, and they actually called it on Justin Walter, and he's got four fouls. So four on Justin, and nobody else out there on the floor has got, well, let's see. Eric Hemmer's got one, and everybody else out there, Nick doesn't have any. Holder doesn't have any. Free throw is no good. They missed three in a row, so maybe they're trying to let us hang in there with them. Ryan Rist misses the first one. 41-30, second free throw, got that one down. 42-30. Hornets need a bucket here. Need to come down, be patient. Work for a good shot. Eric Hemmer, right wing. Comes into the paint, off-balance leaner, bingo. Oh, what a shot by Eric. Here they come down the floor. Perry on the fast break, lays it up and in. Hornets got beat down the floor that time, 44-32. Here's the pass to Nick. Brinkley looks in the paint, dishes. Here's a three-pointer by Justin Walter. It's no good. Rebound by Reeder. Here comes the big man on the dribble. Down to the right wing. There's the pass into Reeder on the give and go. An offensive foul. They wave off the basket. Well, that was a gutsy play because Walter's got four fouls on him, and he got in front of the big man and drew the offensive foul. So a gutsy play by Justin with four fouls on him already. 2:35 left. Here we go. Hornets down by 12. Hornets need to put it in the hole here. They need a bucket here. Need to work for a good shot. They'll swing the Hammer right back. Just Burt on the right wing. There's Hammer with a leaner, and he scores. 44-34. A lot of time left. 2:18, third quarter. Reader to Perry. Now to McNeil up front, top of the key. There's the pass down low. Wrist has it knocked out of his hands. And it was Nick Brinkley that reached in and knocked it out of there. 2:05 left, third quarter. Hornets up, or rather Hornets, well, I can say Hornets up. Hornets of Fulton are up. Here's the back door wide open. And the layup good by Gabe Craighead. 46-34, Justin Walter between the circles, right wing with a Hammer on the wing, looking for the shot, he'll let it fly, bingo, Eric Hammer, they were daring him to shoot the three, and he pops it home, Hornets down by nine, that puts it back into single digits, out front with it, they'll swing to Craighead, top of the circle, now Craighead will take it with a lob down low, it's knocked away, picked up by Reeder on the baseline, stolen, and it was Nick that got a hand on it, Burt now, Justin will take it to the hole, double pumps it in, Hornets down by seven, don't count these young sophomores and juniors out, here's a shot down low, there's Reeder, too easy. Yeah, it's easier said than done, Randy, though. You 6'7", who are you going to, you're double-teaming, somebody else will burn you. But, yeah, they do need to shut him down. But, yeah, out front, Burt Dickinson now to Justin Walter. It's a 9-point lead for Fulton. Down low, there's Holder backing his way to the hole. The shot up and in by Holder. Michael with a nice shot. And 48-41, Hornets down by seven, trying to reach back for a little extra. The steal, here comes Chillicothe, the two-on-one, the shot is up, the shot is in, the foul, and it counted. The basket's down. Hornets have come back. They're down by five. Justin Walter going to the foul line. Oh, baby, don't you dare count them out. Just free throw, good by Walter. It's a 4-point game. Chillicothe down by 13 a while ago, have come back. And look at this young team out there. Look at this young team out there. We do not have a senior on the floor. We had four sophomores on the floor there a while ago. Here's the inbound pass to Perry. Perry now to Reeder. Reeder picked up by Nick. They break the timeline over to their guard, Kirby. Now he'll swing to Perry. Perry with it out front, guarded by just, look at Bird. He's hustling on the defensive end. Kirby now with it, backs it out of there. Brett Hecker's checked in. Now he'll swing over to Perry, and Perry will go high post. There's Reeder, no good. Rebound, Brett Hecker. Well, here comes Chillicothe and pull it within two. The Hornet fans are into it. They're on their feet. The pass, the shot by Nick. No good. Rebound picked up by Burt Dickinson, and the buzzer sounds. That's the end of our third quarter. The Hornet fans are... The Hornets will not give, lay down and die. And here comes Burt, right wing to the Hammer. Hammer looking for the three. Here it is. Missed it short. That was an air ball. On the rebound. And here comes the Fulton fans with their chant. And into the front court, Kirby. Kirby holding up. He wants to run play number two. Kirby on the right wing beyond three. Looks inside up front now. It'll go to Justin Perry. The pass down low. The shot up and no good by Reeder. Reeder missed the shot, but he gets his own rebound and lays it in. Well, Well, that's how they get here, I guess, to the Final Four when you got a man like Reeder. Burt Dickinson with a drive, no good. Rebound is wrist, stolen by Burt. Dickinson has it, Hornets down by six. Robbie Gastineau looks inside. Robbie on the right baseline to the hammer. Eric looking for the shot, puts it down with a left-hand dribble, turnaround leaner. Good! Off the glass, holy cow! Oh my, what a shot by the hammer. Oh, he leaned into his man and let it fly and kissed it off the window. Hornets down by four, 6:48 left. Out front, Fulton now. Oh, they drug their foot. Got away with one. Well, now that was traveling if I ever saw it. You take your pivot foot and slide it clear across the floor, that's traveling. Here's the inbound pass. They get it inside the post. The low blocks. The turnaround finger rolls good. Basket by Gabe Craighead. Hornets down by six. Burt Dickinson in the front court. Now to Eric Hemmer. 6.5 left. Hemmer down low to the baseline. Looks for the shot. Horses it up and in. Eric Hemmer pops it home. And the Hornets hang tough. Excuse me, Randy. Out front with it. It is Kirby. Brian Kirby on the dribble, now swings out front, Craighead. Craighead, left-hand dribble, spins down the edge of the perimeter at the free throw line. They'll swing it out front now and reset it. Perry works against Burt Dickinson, 6:03 left, and a down, an offensive foul! An offensive foul has been called on Fulton. Burt Dickinson with a defensive play. These officials can be sold. And he'll swing to the left wing. Here's Justin Waller with a three. No good. There's Nick with a rebound. Nick Brinkley got the rebound. Justin will have it. Hornets down by four. They can pull within two with a deuce. Nick Brinkley looks for the shot. He's fronted. And they got one on behind him, too. Out front, Burt, right wing. He'll drive down low towards the baseline to Nick Brinkley. Nick looks for the shot. They're daring him to shoot it. Out front, Robbie Gastineau. There's the pass in the paint to Hemmer. And a foul on Reeder. The push. And Eric goes the foul line. Can pull Chillicothe to within two. In the game, Chillicothe trying to hang, trying to pull this one out. There's the free throw by Eric. Good! Oh, he trickled that in off the rim. Ooh. Here we go. Second free throw is up and it is good. Hits them both. And Chillicothe's pulled within two. Fulton has called a timeout. Chillicothe and Fulton, the Fulton Hornets. And they have done it with young, very short players. Fulton now with the ball into the front court, trying to break the timeline. Now they do to Reeder. Reeder, the big man on the dribble. Out front, Kirby. Kirby will go low blocks, and he's doing the two-step. There's a turnaround, Jay, and it falls in. Wrist with it. All right, and Chillicothe now with the ball, down by four. We approach 5 minutes. Burt Dickinson way out front between the circles. Burt will swing to the left wing to Justin Walter. Down low to Eric Hemmer. Hemmer back to Justin, thinking about the three. Turning it down, putting it down instead with a right-hand dribble. Between the circles, now to Burt right wing, down to the baseline, Robbie Gastineau. This continues to be a young team out on the floor. This whole Hornet team is young. Outside, Burt look for the three. The pass to Nick. Nick inside, threw it away. And here comes Fulton now the other way with it. They'll come to Reeder. Look out. Reeder with a horse of a move and travels with the ball. Oh, what a play by Burt Dickinson. Hornets will get it. Burt did the only thing he could do. You ought to have seen that, folks. That was fun. 6-7 against 5. 9 3/4. Justin Walter with a three-pointer. It rims out. Oh, boy. The Hornets wanted that one. That thing pinballed out of there. Chillicothe down by 4. Here comes Kirby. That was a great play a while ago by Dickinson. He knew he couldn't block him. He knew he couldn't intimidate him. He just went for the last second steal and got it done. Here's a pass down low to the blocks. Reeder horsing his way to the hole, and he's knocked down. Traveling, Nick Brinkley with the defensive play. Well, Nick that time with an Oscar. Yeah, the Hornets have plenty of time still left. Under 4 minutes, the Hornets need to put it in the hole here. Down low to the hammer. Down to the baseline. Eric will kick it out. Walter, they'll swing it around Dickinson. Burt on the right wing beyond 3. Looks for the shot. Down low. They'll swing it out. There's Burt turning the 3 down. Down to the baseline. Nick Brinkley rainbows one. Won't fall. Rebound inside by Fulton. Here comes Kirby in a backcourt foul on Robbie Gastineau. Well, I tell you what, folks, you all ran in, came charging back. That takes some guts. That takes some, you got to reach down there and pull that out. I mean, and this team's got it. This team has got a lot of nice young players that bust their tails off. 55-50, second one no good. Tipped up and in. Oh, boy. That time Nick didn't screen out Reeder, and Reeder just tipped it in, and that's a three-point play. Now Jeff Snockenberg says to the official, come here, I want to talk to you. I want to talk to you. And now they're having a conference. We got a timeout as they have a chit-chat. And I bet you he's not asking him out for supper tonight. Zone. They'll swing left wing. There's Walter. They'll swing to the right wing now to the hammer down low. There's the shot by Holder. No good. Nick gets the rebound. Throws it out to Walter. Three-pointer on the way. No good. Nick Brinkley fights for the board. Oh, Nick, what a nice play, but a jump ball is called, and the arrow points the wrong way. Points to Fulton. 3:02 left. Well, you know, Nick just ran over. Nick didn't see him, I don't think. He ran over Justin Perry.
And that'll be a 1-1 for Perry.
Well, shot in that first half. Under 50% free throw. No good. There's that big horse again. Tips it up. It's no good. It's rebounded by Holder. Here comes Chillicothe. Here comes the 3-on-2. The driving layup. Count it. Chillicothe's pulled within 5. Boy, that was a quick, strong move to the hole by the little guard. The sophomore at 5'9". Fulton Hornets with a ball out front. Now they're going to spread them out here. I'll bet you money. Watch them here. They're not going to look for the shot, are they? They look like they're going to. Now they foul, and that's all right, I think. He'll get the 1 in bonus here. First one is up, and it is good. Now they got some size. This has all been done with Bland on the bench. Justin has not played more than a quarter and a half. He came out at the end of the first quarter, and he got the foul out in the third quarter. Second free throw's good. Chillicothe now with the ball. Bert Dickinson out with it. Now left wing down low to Nick. Nick Brinkley trying to drive baseline. Gets stuck inside. Holder goes to the hole. Lays it up. It's blocked. It's going to be picked up inside by the big man from Fulton. 2:15 left. 59-52. Here comes Fulton now. They're going to try to run it out in the backcourt foul, or rather front court foul, but just across the time. Call 3 seconds on you. So you come in there, eventually you're going to have to shoot that ball or give it up pretty quick and get out of there. Well, he missed the first one, and he got the second one. He got 1 out of 2. Hornets down by 8. Here comes Walter into the front court. Do you shoot a 3 here? Eric Hemmer down to the baseline. Looks, takes a long deuce. It won't fall. Weak side board. Michael Holder. Michael with a good job down on that baseline. They'll look for the Hemmer. Bert Dickinson out to Eric. Eric will put it down. Left-hand dribble. Top of the key. Passes over to Nick. Right back. Eric, a three-pointer. Good! Good! 60-55. Hornets down by 5. Gutsy performance here tonight by the Hornets. Free throw, pinballs out. No good. Too much ketchup on the hot dog. He'll get another one here, 60 to 55. Can he make it? Second one on the way. Good. You got one of two. That's all right. We come down, get three, and then give them one. We come down, get three, then give them one. Bert Dickinson threw it away. Well, Bert tried to dish it in the paint. There wasn't anybody home. And now a foul on Bert in the backcourt. Kind of glad it's winding down, Randy. Yeah. And you're older than I am, aren't you? Well, that's old. You're old. 62. 55. Free throw is up and in. He'll get another one. Second one is on the way, and it's good. That's an 8-point lead. Here comes Chillicothe. There's Eric with a three. No, he didn't get set that time. Didn't get his feet set. Didn't get square. There's the steal, and Fulton gets it right back. Oh, the Hornets had it, and the ball bumped or one of them's head, I think. Fulton now into the... At the timeline, they'll throw to the wing, to wrist, and a Hornets foul. 63-55, Hornets down by eight, but a couple more land on the bench. And they did it with, they came back, really, with Walter and Dickinson, their two starting guards, but they had Holder in there. You're looking at some of the Hornets of the future there. Of course, Nick will be back next year. Holder's going to be a player. Now, they got a lot of juniors over there. Michael Snowden's done for this year, but they got Gastineau. You got Ryan Beyer now. The senior's going to check in. Here's a three-pointer. Good by Bert Dickinson. A three-pointer. And it's a seven-point game with a minute left. We got a timeout here, I think, don't we?
Ryan Beyer.
Free throw is up and in, 66-58. I thought Snock doing a good job getting Ryan Beyer in there, the senior. He'll remember this for the rest of his life down here at the Final Four, getting to play in the game. They got him in there. Both free throws are good, 67-58. Hornets need a miracle. Here's a three-pointer by Justin Walter. Won't go. Rebound Holder. Justin will let it fly again. His three-pointer no good. Rebound on the weak side by Wrist. And a backcourt foul on Eric Hemmer. That's about all you can do. And this thing is over. Four. And I thought Snock, the players, all of them, did a very proud of what they accomplished here. Free throw up and in. I had a sneaking suspicion Fulton was going to win this thing by double digits, and right now it's 68-58. And the second one is good. 69-58. Hornets lost last night by 10. They trail by 11 here. Here's a pass to the right wing. Ryan drives in. Nice move. Ryan Beyer. Oh, he wishy. That thing trickled off the rim. Ryan with a nice drive, and now the backcourt foul by Ryan Beyer.
I think that's something we all need to keep in mind.
Free throw is up and in by the big man, Matt Reeder. We mentioned this before the game. Only two teams in the state of Missouri in Class 3A will win their final game of the season. And that'll be Fulton here winning the third place game, and then whoever wins the championship here tonight. They've got Johnson and Jones and everybody else in there. Here's the free throw, no good. Brett Hecker with a rebound. Here comes Bert Dickinson with 31 seconds left. Bert's going to take the three. No, Hemmer's going to let it fly. It's short. And the rebound goes to Fulton, and a backcourt foul is going to be called on Brett Hecker. Everybody is going to get in the game. And I like this. 25 seconds, same way with Fulton. Get them all in. Get them. They can say that you never know. They may not ever get here again.
Or they may get here again the next year or two. Tigers stand in front of the crowd three, four, five times what you normally play in.
Yeah, and they can tell their kids and grandkids, hey, I was out there on the Hearn Center with where the Missouri Tigers play. They can even tell the Colonel, hey, Colonel, I played at the Hearn Center. And the free throw is up, and it is good. And the second one, it's no good. And the rebound is tipped around. Chillicothe with a rebound. 21 seconds left. Here come the Hornets in a hurry. Josh Bruce takes it down to the paint. They'll swing to Turner, and the three-pointer is no good. Rebound inside. The shot up and in. The basket inside. Oh, what a shot. And the Hornets come down. There's a shot, no good, and a foul is called. Jason Vorbeck gets on the scoring column there.
They sent in about 25 players in the last 30 seconds.
Free throw is up and no good.
They just sent three more.
They're taking. Now, they got some of them fans over there they're sending in. That's what they're doing. They're the band.
The band behind them, yeah.
The trombone player's in. Free throw's up and in. 72-60. Trombone. Now, here comes the tuba player, and we got a backcourt foul. And the foul is on that little guy out there from Fulton. Bruce at the foul line, the freshman for Chillicothe. His free throw is on the way, and it is no good. He falls his rebound. Here's the shot. No good. Tipped up and in. Oh, nice play in there. Andrew Singleton tips it in, and the Hornets have lost both games down here by 10 points. Our final here tonight, the Fulton Hornets have defeated the Chillicothe Hornets 72-62, and this season has come to an end.
It's more than a contest, it's more.